If you are new to Umbraco, finding your way around the Backoffice might be a bit difficult. In this video, I'll guide you through each dashboard and section of the fantastic Umbraco Backoffice so that you know how you can structure the site, add new content, and so much more. My name is Jakob, let my voice guide you through this journey. Let me start by explaining the basic structure of the Backoffice. Up top, we have the navigation, and on the navigation, going from the left, we have the vent sections. On the far end of the navigation, there's a search function, help section, and your profile. Just below the navigation, we have two sections. And that is tree view on the left side, containing all the items under the specific dashboard, and on the right side, a details view, which displays data about the item you selected in the left section. To give you a better understanding of how it looks like, let me just click this node and look at this. The details view updates to display information we have on the item we select in the view on the left. This basic structure is true for every single section in a hardcore installation. So you will see the same behavior on the content, as well as on the media, settings, and so on. One important thing to note, while all of the nodes here are clickable, so is the text or name of the dashboard, and that gives you access to some more options specific to a dashboard you are on. At the moment we are on the content menu. This is where all your content is, and that is the stuff that is delivered via the CDN. So if we once again click on this home node over here, all the properties and text and possibly images we have on it will show up on the right. Up top, we can see we have a content tab with properties. We can switch to the info tab, which gives us a bit more information about what links this content would have, as well as its status, publishing history, document type it is using, and its ID. There's also actions you can access, stuff such as deleting, moving, copying the notes, and so on. And what's super nice is that you can also access this actions menu by right-clicking on a note in the tree view on the left. Same stuff as you can see. Let's move on to the media section. Everything here is very similar to the content section, except instead of page notes, media stores your images, music, PDF, videos, and such. The navigation is exactly the same. You also have access to info and actions. Next up is settings, and that is a bit more complex. It comes with some predefined folders. In settings, you can build your basic site structure by adding new document types. Document types are super important in Umbraco, as they're a framework for your content. Just to show you what I mean, I can only fill out a header for home on my content dashboard because I defined the header as a property. Like this. It's called, in this case, title or hero title. And that's what we see if we go to the content and go on the homepage. And for the document types, we also have some different tabs up here. We are at the moment on design. Then we have a list view, which essentially controls how the children of this document type will show up in the content. There's also permissions, which is super useful because this is where you decide what kind of children you can make under this specific node type, as well as set up whether this document type will let you create content for different languages. So in this case, we have the front page or the home page, and under the home page, we can make a simple text page. Some other important aspects of the settings dashboard, that would be the headless menu here, with the API browser, GraphQL playground, webhooks, and some other. And these items are exclusive to Heartcore. You can find out more about those in the documentation I link below. Next up, we have the users. And what are users? Those are the type of people who have access to the Backoffice, and they are able to modify content, document types, and so on. As you can see, that also includes me. And next to users, we have members, and you might say, that's very similar. So what's the difference? Members, unlike the users, do not have access to the Backoffice. If you are building a front-end login functionality, perhaps a shop site, a web shop, this is where you can save your customers, and they will not be able to log into the Backoffice. This could serve as your small little own database of your website's users. The last section is called Forms, and that is a package that we developed, which is available by default on all cloud projects. It allows you to easily build, for example, a contact form for your customers by adding specific fields one by one. Like so. That was an overview of the Umbraco Heartcore Backoffice. I hope the video helps you get started on your new project. Thank you for watching and have a fantastic day.